creature you heard, what does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay. Enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want, too.
Left leg! Come on, Kratos! Off your back!
Yeah!
Right side!
Well, no, I don't want to abandon it. But if we have to kill a bunch of Dark Elves to get there...
I remember a young lad who, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not making the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't. Through here, I think.
These things smell awful.
Ah!
There, that bomb should help us. It's just, why does it feel like no matter what we do in Alphine, we wind up hurting Dark Elves?
We are down here to help the creature you hurt.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
Left foot! Help us!
Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lunge. We'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last good thing we saw was Diener, so...
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. Yeah!
From the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Half-goofers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the dark elves. Any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources. One the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the Hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this Hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
Thank you.
This is the spot! We can cut the house Koopa loose here!
It's a half goofa.
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone.
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnar, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad. While he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
Back to my story. A thane of my homeland, manipulated by prophecy, welcomes his king as a guest and murders him in his sleep.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Story. A thane of my homeland, manipulated by prophecy, welcomes his king as a guest and murders him in his sleep. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper. With just a few details, structured ever so misleadingly, they convinced the people he was invulnerable to all threats.
Physical or magical?
Aye. But was not so for him. All turned into a rather magnificent bloodbath as they go. The Thane ends up without his head and a name so cursed, none dare speak it. All thanks to a subtly deceptive prophecy.
You really gotta write these stories down one day, Mimir.
Well, I try. Jaw tends to get sore, but thank you, lad. I can play beautifully, you know.
I... not. And would prefer it remain that way. Ha! Yeah.
Come on, brother. Let's have it. You mentioned you had a favorite poem from your homeland. What was it about?
A cunning general. A war over forbidden love.
I believe I've heard of this one. Did it involve a horse that was not as it appeared?
Yes. But that is not what happened.
Oh, it's based on truth then. And you were there.
Yes. I prefer the poem.
Father, can we build a lyre together?
The instrument. Why?
We hunt, we train. Those are the only two things you do to distract yourself.
They are not distractions.
Oh, of course not.
I just thought it'd be nice to learn some music. You could teach me, and... No. It's stupid. Never mind. Like a lot of the sand is cleared up. But there's another storm out that way. You think that means...
Another half, Gufa.
The chisel will not open this.
Did the Lighthouse put this lock here? Why would they care what happens in the Barrens?
A fair question. But until we find the right key, that poor half Gufa will have to continue its solo act.
Father, why do I look like you?
In what way?
Like, bigger. When do I get muscles like yours?
When you work for them.
But Baldur was really strong, and he didn't have any muscles.
My strength does not come from my body, but both are honed by discipline.
What's that mean?
It means you've got the strength of a god no matter what, lad. But if you want the physique of one, you'd better start picking heavy things up and putting him back down.
Thank you. bloody Draugr.
Take it off, man. You've got that. You're on fire, Pritor. It will pass.
Bloody Draugr.
Yappa!
Bloody Draugr.
It's
bad! Nasty hit! All right, brother!
Yappa!
bloody Draugr.
Reminds me of tales of a cruel empress, one too angry to die.
We will see.
Two of you, how I made a small fortune in Asgard. Once, Baldur arranged for every archer in the city to open fire on him.
We took bets on how many arrows could be lodged in his body until the sheer weight of them made him fall down. Ha!
That's awful.
Oh, no, no. He was laughing the whole time. And mine was the closest guess. 446 arrows. Exactly.
It's horrible. You better not tell that story in front of Freya.
Yes, lad. Because I've suddenly taken leave of my senses.
Just saying.
Mm-hmm.